PeopleSoft HCM introduces an enhanced framework that supports data lockdown and components during payroll processing, on a predefined schedule, or on demand. A lockdown event contains information about when a lockdown occurs, who is impacted by the lockdown, the user, role, or product key, which components are locked, and a message explaining why a component is locked. When a user tries to access a locked component, the system displays a message indicating the component is locked and can't be updated. Your organization can configure this message. Click OK to view the page in read-only mode. Let's look at the HCM Lockdown Framework configuration pages. Enter Lockdown Framework Setup in Global Search. The Lockdown Framework Setup page shows the created navigation collection with all of the components that we'll cover. First, define and indicate the components you want to mark as lockdown eligible using Lockdown Component Eligibility. You can search for components by Object Owner ID or Component Name. On the Component Eligibility page, you can define which components are eligible for a lockdown event. Select the Eligible for Lockdown checkbox to identify and make the components eligible for lockdown. You don't have to add people code anymore. Event mapping takes care of that when you save your choices. You can verify the enabled status in the Lockdown Enabled Status column. The filter option allows you to verify whether all your identified components are marked as eligible. Use the Lockdown Component Group page to group components that are eligible for lockdown. These groups are used when you define a lockdown event. Only lockdown-enabled components can be added to these groups. Lockdown groups define who is included or excluded from a lockdown. You can create lockdown groups using the Lockdown User Group page based on users, roles, or product keys. The lockdown member's grid is dynamic and based on the group type. Product keys are used to define what drives a particular process. For example, payroll processes for Payroll for North America are based on company and pay group, while global payroll and absence management are driven by pay group. You can include or exclude selected members from the lockdown group, or select applies to all, if the group type is product key. The last step is to define your events. On the lockdown event definition page, you can specify when, why, and for whom the components should be locked. Lockdown events can be general, process-based, or on demand. General is used when you want to lock the system according to a schedule or at a specified time. Use the process-based option when you want to initiate lockdown while a process is running. For example, payroll. On demand is used when you need to lock the system immediately. Let's look at a general or scheduled lockdown event. The lockdown options allows you to specify when the lockdown should be in effect. The on-demand option allows you to lock down the system immediately using any of the existing lockdown events, or you can create your own definition. The lockdown message lets you explain why users are locked out. This message appears when you access a page that is locked down. The lockdown user group determines who gets locked out, defined as users, roles, or product keys. The component group ID determines which pages get locked out. Use the lockdown schedule options to enable, disable, or delete the lockdown schedules. These fields are only enabled if the lockdown option of Use Schedule has been selected. Use the lockdown schedule to define the dates and times when the lockdown should be active or inactive. Now, let's look at a process-based lockdown event. The only difference for this event is that instead of a schedule, you need to specify the process and phases that should trigger the lockdown. For payroll for North America, the phases are pay sheets, calculation, preliminary and final, and confirmation. For global payroll and absence management, the phases are identify, calculate, including final, and finalize. For instance, you might want to only lock the system during final calculation and confirm or finalize. You can also keep the system locked until all phases are complete, such as from final calculation through confirmation or finalize. Lockdowns can also be disabled during off-cycle processing. All other functions are the same as shown in a general-based event. The Manage Lockdown Events page lets you view all the lockdown events you have defined. Access a specific event using the link in the description column to view the definition. You can override the lockdown options for a selected lockdown event without accessing the Lockdown Event Definition page. This is especially useful if you need to perform an on-demand lockdown. Now, let's discuss some of the delivered components. The Process Phase Setup page allows you to configure processes and phases for a product or country that are used to lock down the components. For payroll for North America and global payroll, including absence management, these definitions are delivered. You can also define off-cycle options. Lockdown components use this configuration to capture phases that appear in the event definitions later. You can define key values or drivers to help define groups for lockdown beyond users and roles. This is delivered by PeopleSoft and defines the rules for payroll for North America and global payroll. If you have a custom process and want to use this feature, there's a technical brief that explains the changes you'll need to make. The Locking Overrides page enables you to override standard event mapping definitions, which occur when the component eligibility table is updated. This enables you to write your own logic. You can still use the delivered APIs to determine whether the component must be locked and add your own criteria to lock. As delivered, the Component Lockdown Framework supports component lockdown capabilities in global payroll, absence management, and payroll for North America processes. The HCM Lockdown Framework is a powerful framework that allows you to lock any HCM component for a group of people based on a schedule, process, or on demand. It doesn't need customization because the logic to lock a component is triggered when the user goes to a page. You can extend this logic by using the delivered APIs and overriding the delivered code. For more information, go to peoplesoftinfo.com.